Decriminalization of all drugs is on the ballot in the state of Oregon. And if the voters in Oregon approve this ballot measure, it could be an interesting experiment in this country, an experiment that we haven't had yet. So it's measure 110, and it wants to provide people who are struggling with drug addiction with the healthcare and the rehabilitation that they need, rather than just criminalizing them and placing them behind bars. Oregon's measure 110 would remove criminal penalties for the personnel. Oregon's measure 110 could remove criminal penalties for the personal, non-commercial possession of a controlled substance, while giving people caught with small amounts of drugs the option to either pay a fine of no more than $100 or get a completed health assessment done through an addiction recovery center. The measure would decriminalize all drugs classified Schedule 1, it's amazing, 2, 4 under the law, including cocaine, heroin, and meth. And so some people might be thinking, this is awful, this is a terrible idea, because it's going to promote the usage of these hard drugs, they're dangerous, it might increase addiction. But what we've seen in other case studies is that the opposite happens. So Portugal actually decided to go in this direction and notice that when they approached it from a public health perspective as opposed to a criminal perspective, they were able to offer people the help they needed, the rehabilitation they needed, and drug use actually went down. Because nothing makes drug use less cool than the government telling you that you won't be criminalized for it. So, and also people usually use these drugs because they're in a tough spot. They might be in a terrible place in their lives and they need help. We all know that it's a public health issue. So rather than penalizing them and putting them behind bars, which of course ruins the rest of their lives, why not spend that money on getting them the help that they need?
I'm a little bit worried about this becoming a trend. Like, I know that the first 60 years or so of just criminalizing it and putting more and more people on the border hasn't worked, but I think the next decade really would have done it. I think that would have solved all of the problems. Telling people not to do the drugs and throwing them in jail, that would have really worked. You're right. This is not a totally new thing. It has been tried. It has been tried both here. It has been tried internationally. And when you look at the not just the public health consequences of the current way that we address this, but the effect that it has on people's lives when you criminalize it, all that that does, that's how is that better? Like, hypothetically, you know, you could lock people up for speeding, and theoretically that would stop some speeding, but think about the damage that it would be done to so many people's lives along the way. And for some reason, we have taken, out of all of the potential criminal activity, we've taken drug consumption as some sort of activity that we're gonna look at fundamentally differently than everything else, no matter the cost in human lives, no matter how long it takes, no matter how much money. And it'll be good to see some places actually experiment.
Shai from our member section wrote in and said, how many people of color are serving years in prison for smoking pot or for jaywalking or worse? Yet the Sacklers, meaning the family behind Purdue Pharma, have museums, universities, and graveyards named after them. Yeah. Well, the graveyards, I think, would probably make sense. They provided quite a bit of business for graveyards, the Sackler family. But I think that you raise a really great point. The Sackler family has admitted guilt in fueling the opioid epidemic. And at the same time, when it comes to drugs like pot, you know, these prohibition policies have been used to perpetuate racism in this country. I mean, the systemic racism that we talk about is so obvious in our justice system. And when you consider, you know, the population of black individuals in this country in relation to the number of black people in prison for pot possession, I mean, how can you deny that these policies are implemented in a way to put more and more black people and people of color behind bars? It's just, it's what we've noticed, it's what we've seen, and it has a chilling effect on the community. They're unable to go about their lives after they get out because they have a felony on their record. That's not the way we should be treating people. We should be providing help and support. Now, in the coverage of this story, the only downsides that we heard from came from cops. Case closed, it's over. Okay, so I'm very curious to see how this plays out. I hope that this ballot initiative is passed and we see how it works out in Oregon.
Thanks for watching the Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun, but you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.